This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA. And by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com.
Welcome back to How to Corespun Yarn. And in this tutorial, we will be corespunning over elastic to make a stretchy corespun yarn. The elastic I am using, I found at my local craft store, and it's thread for smocking dresses. In the elastic tutorial that I made for plied, I used stretchy clear beading elastic. Either one of these will work for this tutorial. I prefer the smocking elastic for corespinning because it has a bit of kind of rough texture from cotton thread on top of it, and it makes it easier for the fibers to kind of grab onto it. And so since my elastic wants to be on the floor, it's going to be on the floor. On the bobbin, I have the wire technique that I just wrapped up. So I'm going to just pretend that that is a leader thread. And I'm going to be corespinning a art bat by Feisty Fen Fibers. We'll just rip off a section of this. And I have my elastic thread looped over my pretend leader. Spinning in a counterclockwise direction, I'm going to pinch the art bat onto the elastic thread until it grabs a hold of it and slowly draft it back. And the key to spinning elastic yarn is you always want to keep your elastic thread under tension. And that way, when you let go, it bunches up and creates that stretchy texture. If I were to spin over this elastic and not keep it under tension, just keep it loose, there would be no stretch in it at all. It would end up being drapey, like the elastic thread is when you don't pull on it. So let's get this wire onto the bobbin. Cool. Okay. Spinning in a clockwise direction, holding the elastic under tension to stretch it out, and then having your thread, having your fiber spin on top of it. Let's bump up our tension. Now, a couple tips. Make sure that your fiber is tightly wrapped on your core thread so that when it relaxes like this, it doesn't puff out or create weird loops or become separated from the elastic thread. Another tip is don't spin too bulky on top of your elastic thread, because I found that that also creates really loosey-goosey, bumpy textures that sometimes separate from the elastic thread. And so you see the elastic thread and it doesn't feel super secure. So I like to corespun fiber over the elastic nice and tight and secure. So the way that I'm holding this is I'm just kind of drafting fiber out and holding it with my thumb and my pointer finger and letting it wrap onto the elastic at usually a 90 degree angle, sometimes maybe closer to 80, maybe 70 if I'm getting lazy. If you're uncomfortable using one hand to draft, you can just wrap it on top of the fiber using this motion. Pull the fiber out, wrap it on. I almost find that if you get a big slump and you wrap it on, just hold both tight, I guess, to get a nice tight twist. So some troubleshooting. Let's say that you are overly zealous about keeping your elastic thread under tension and it breaks. What do? Tie it in a knot and corespin over the knot, and no one will ever know. Let's say you make a really loosey-goosey part of elastic. This is what I don't like to do, but it's pretty cool because when you, it almost is like, see how I can pull it off the elastic? So let's say you accidentally do this. Let's say you're like, oh, I want to do something different. And then you realize my yarn is falling apart. I would scrunch that up and kind of pull the fiber off and just wrap it around tighter. Maybe, yeah, get some more fiber and wrap it on top just to lock it down, lock it down, lock it down. And see how that is. Much better. Super solid. Super solid. And I think that's all the troubleshooting I can think of from problems I've had with elastic yarn. My favorite time I ever spun elastic was at a Camp Plucky Fluff. Lexi had us card bats that represented who we were as people. And then we spun it on elastic. And then when we took it off using a skein winder or nitty knotty, we tied it in four sections, and when we put it on the floor, it kind of looked like a brain, and they represented our brain. This is your brain on fiber. And mine was gray, and it was full of junk in it. It was full of scraps of yarn and sparkle and random stuff, and that was my brain at the time. I think if I were to spin my brain now, that's a good question. Let me think about that a little bit. Who am I now? Who are you now? If you were to card a bat and spin yourself as a yarn, what color would you be? I think I'm done with this technique. That was fast. I mean, I could keep spinning and spinning, but I think you've seen all. Anyway, let me show you how to end it. So you just snap the thread, tie it in a knot, and then so as not to, I'm going to hold the tension right here, because if this becomes really loosey-goosey, we're going to have that same problem where it falls apart. So this is one of those yarns that needs to be kept under tension forever. Okay, nice and tight under tension, and you can even set it with a steamer. But don't let it go wobbly, or else you'll have to retwist it. And I'm not even going to take it off the bobbin. I'll bring this in closer so you can see what it looks like on the bobbin. So that's what it looks like on the bobbin. This is from a wire yarn tutorial that I did. Here's our elastic. Really pretty, super cute. Works great when you take it off the wheel as a ready-to-wear cowl. So no knitting required to use this yarn. Thank you for watching, and happy spinning.